नमस्कार, अस्सलाम वालेकुम एंड गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल ऑफ यू। ऑनरेबल चेयरपर्सन्स, पैनलिस्ट, माय को स्पीकर्स, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक्स द ऑर्गेनाइजर्स ऑफ इंडो यूएस सिंपोजियम एंड स्पेशली टू डॉक्टर एस के शर्मा, एडवाइजर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ आयुष, फॉर गिविंग मी दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी टू शेयर माई efforts with you people. Friends, it's a journey, it's a story of a Vaidya. I'm a Ras Vaidya, I make my medicines. Ras means I deal with therapeutics of mercury and heavy metals, which are prepared with the substances of plant and mineral origin. So I have nearly 25 years of clinical practice, which I acquired from my father, who was also a Vaidya, and he had a guru. So I'm doing in three generation, and from that clinical practice, today it has converted into a partnership with a leading pharma company. It's called Ipca Laboratory Limited, Mumbai, which is one of the leading pharma company of India dealing with modern medicine and in bulk drugs. So I was asked to talk about the research methodology, and here I would like to start with the first slide. That's an opportunity, and I feel that I'm blessed that I born and brought up in India, which is the only country in the world where different systems of medicines are officially recognized as a medical system of, as an independent medical system. It is the only country where I can treat patients. I'm registered in UAE as a medical professional. I've passed my exam in Oman also, where I'm a medical professional. But a pity that these countries are recognizing Ayurveda as a system, but I cannot use my medicines. So I'm a soldier without weapon. But here, I am a Vaidya who can treat patient in parallel to like allopathic counterparts. And the unique feature of this practice is that Drug and Cosmetic Act clearly allows that a practitioner of Ayurveda and Unani can prepare medicines at his, for his own clinical practice. So this is a unique opportunity. We can prepare and we can give directly to the patients. Nowhere else this opportunity is not available. And I take this opportunity that BAMS, which is my degree, is Bachelor of Ayurvedic Medicine and Surgery, can play an important role like bridge between Ayurveda and modern science, because I work like a formulation manager. I work like a clinical pharmacist, and here I could document as a clinical researcher. And there is another model where you can treat, but you can collaborate with other doctors. There may be rule that there is a cross prescription is not allowed, but nobody stops us when different system of medicines practitioners work together. So this is a tremendous opportunity, and we can document our practice following this. And when I was doing it, I found there was an existing model of research. Today when I was in the lecture, it's a great opportunity that I came across with the learned lecture of Professor R.S. Singh, his comment. He was talking about penicillin, 1948. So there was no trial. So before 1948, whatever the medicines, whatever the invention came in the world, they came through this route, positive observation. Observation of James Watt lead to steam engine. Observation of Newton lead to the gravity. Observation of penicillin lead to penicillin, nitrous oxide by a Boston dentist who found. So these were the model, which observation within set parameter lead to hypothesis, and hypothesis with the help of experiment were converted into theories. But alas, the companies, the countries who followed this path in 16th century, 17th century, 18th century, 19th century, now they say, no, it should be concept to clinic. $1.8 billion. 15 years, we cannot embark this model at all because we don't have that much money. So I follow this model, which was developed in the West, which was followed up in the West. And the first example is acute promyelocytic leukemia. I found in my clinical practice that one of the leukemia which was responding the most, that was acute promyelocytic leukemia, whether relapsing or de novo cases or defaulter cases. So this was my preliminary observation in my clinic. Based on that, I approached the authorities in the Department of Ayush. Yes, it took just 14 years to convince them, but finally I got it. And it was a cancer research committee comprising of doctors from AIIMS, Maulana Hospital, CCRS, ICMR, esthetician, and they said, you have to treat 15 patients under control condition in CRI building, and you will document each and everything. I was ready for it. And finally, outcome came, and I'm very happy that one of the witness of this project is sitting with us, Honorable Mrs. Shailja Chandraji, who was secretary to the Department of Ayush that time. She was witness of this study, and she's here. So based on this observation, what we found, that silver-based compound, a medicine which is based on silver bhasma and two herbs, was found effective in that. And friends, I am glad to say that the first patient who was treated by this practice has completed now 27 years survival without any side effect. What has happened then? Then this brought US and European patent to us. And the first case which we are referred here, 12 years survival after second relapse of APML, was just published by our co-chairperson, Dr. Bhushan Patwardhanji. And when we were searching the literature, we didn't find that any such survival is there. And then now the job is very easy. Pharma industry is excited that they got a tool. So reverse pharmacology, standardization of medicine, toxicology, efficacy, etc., etc. That is their job, not my job. I've done my job. What we do? We continue to treat patients. Myself? No. I have fair number of Ayurvedic doctors, 7 Ayurvedic doctors, who are using the same treatment protocol, same diagnostic parameter for the treatment of APML. And one of the leading oncologists from Jaipur, he's so much sensitized that he treats this treatment as a first line of treatment in his clinical practice. And this study, as I said, that out of 88 patients, 15 patients were sponsored by Central Council for Research in Ayurveda and Siddha, Department of Ayush. My topic was migraine. So this was a disease, APML, and I was charged, I was excited by this success. So the second model I took, migraine. Migraine is a disease. Because when I treated APML, people say, oh, only 2,000 cases. You should treat a disease which affects millions. Now, there is a disease which affects millions. 280 million people in the world suffer with it. And 30 million alone come from United States of America. And out of 30 million, 4% patients are those who have given up their life, given up their job, because of the transformation of the migraine. And the burden of this disease is about $11 billion a year. This is the direct burden, sir. If we take indirect burden, that is $23 billion in terms of how many manpower, how many things have been wasted. So this disease, which has a burden of $11 billion in a country like USA, and this is the reference which we collected from Headache, the International Journal on Headache. So what is migraine? I think most of you people are aware of it, because I cannot cover everything in 20 minutes. Migraine is the most common form of headache with debility-causing characteristic. There is a no known cause for this disease. And when the cause is not there, treatment is focused on treating the symptoms. Treating the symptoms, and many theories are there, prophylaxis. But whatever the treatment is, whether treatment, management of pain, or prophylaxis, it is clearly known that prolonged use of such medicines can bring moderate to severe side effect. And migraine still remains a big challenge to the world. As I said, I'm a Vaidya. I recall my first patient in 1985 who was brought to me, had gone through many Ayurvedic physician, allopathic physician, because I belong to Meerut, so Meerut Medical College, that patient had all the files. What I found, I was very puzzled. And I learned basic of Ayurveda. Charak says Hetu Ling Aushad. Hetu means cause. Ling means symptoms and Aushad. First of all, establish the cause. Rogam Adho Parikshet Tatarantar Aushadam. These are the basic things which I have learned, that first of all you have to diagnose the disease, then treat the patient. I said, how come so many doctors are failing? I took the basic pulse, Ashtavidh Pariksha. And what I found, that patient has Pitta Nadi, little tenderness over the abdomen in certain parts, And the symptom was Bhramo, Murcha, Aruchi, Shardi, Alasya, Chai, Shuraruja. So while my colleagues were talking about migraine as a disease of head, I found the etiology of migraine lies in the GIT. And based on that, these were the cause of Shleshma Pitta, which is written in Madhav Nidan, long gap of eating. It is a lifestyle, it is an eating pattern, which disturbs physiological changes in the body, and that might be triggering Shiroruja, headache with nausea, vomiting, etc. Based on that, I developed a treatment protocol, then how to normalize the body metabolism, 3 meals, 3 snacks, 8 hours sleeps, and combination of 4 Ayurvedic medicines, which are classical medicines, and it is not mentioned, they are used for migraine. But these are Narikal Laman from Rastarangni. Numex is a combination of Sushekhar Siddhopaladi, Siddhyog Sangra, Rasonvati Siddhyog Sangra, and Godanti Missioners Siddhyog Sangra. Friends, the first success in 1985 still continues. And we developed in-house, because the reproducibility of the medicine is the key. So in so many years, major concern was how to ascertain reproducibility, and now we have full-fledged methodology to reproduce these medicines again and again at our laboratory in Dehradun. Our methodology was clear. We use IHS diagnostic criteria. While we say Shleshma Pitta, but this Shleshma Pitta is very compatible with the established diagnostic criteria of IHS, which says minimum 5 years, minimum 5 attacks in a year, 4 to 72 hours duration, unilateral, bilateral, pulsating, moderate to severe. So whatever the IHS criteria is, it is similar to Shleshma Pitta. We use VASI scoring for the intensity of pain and MIDAS of the impact of migraine on the body of the individual patient. The patient who came to us, they were willing, they gave consent. They paid for their treatment. It was not free treatment. And we made a universal postcard registry system. When a patient came, we said, can you sign your CRF? And can you sign this postcard? And the stamp of the postcard were kept as a proof of the registration. And we did follow up. And even I say that first patient in 1985, he is still in touch with us. And as I said, 1985 to 2002, it was my practice. And first time in 2002, we did a prospective study in a Dhanvantri Ayurvedic College. And this project was sponsored by Dabur India Limited that time. And we have an independent data monitoring committee who were doing it. The second study, we started in Bangalore itself. It is a coincidence. Given in 2005, we started. Dr. R.M. Verma, founder director of NIMHANS, was instrumental for it. And there were many Ayurvedic doctors. And one of the doctors who is participating in it, Vaidya Raghavendra Babu, is sitting here with us. He and his 17 colleagues used the same protocol, same treatment, and we did that thing. And the third study, again, we did in Dehradun, Bangalore, Mysore. And dividend was there. This was the first international symposium on migraine in UK, which was only for hardcore neurologists. It was not for alternate physician. I was preparing for it. I sent my abstract saying that, sir, I'm not a neurologist. I don't have the degree which you are looking for. I'm not a PhD person, but this is my work. Will you accept it? One good thing is with white people, they merit, they value the merit. They said, can you send the manuscript? I said, sir, I can. But that was not enough. They sent 2 auditors. And the first auditor asked me, which I was ready and I was working for, how will you ascertain that you have 267 patients only? I said, sir, hang on. I brought my file of postcard, which has full of stamps of the post office. And that was the first entry. And friends, I'm very pleased to share that the first reference in the medical journal was created through this poster, Cephalalgia, 2006, volume 26, number 11, page 1367. We did not stop. Now this treatment was given to other Ayurvedic doctors who were willing to share this practice in their clinic. And this second paper, this time no scrutiny, no debate, because in the past time I was given in membership of International Headache Society. Again, out of 700 members of International Headache Society, today I'm the only one who is from the alternate practitioner who has that membership. So this poster was presented in Sweden, International Headache Congress in 2007, and it was the continued work but it was the work of 17 Ayurvedic doctors. And what we showed in the previous paper and in this paper, the patient who completed 120 days protocol, 70% patient were without pain and without painkiller. And we followed up for 30 months these cases. Practice continues, and this year it was in Los Angeles, 52nd American Headache Society Scientific Meet. And again, it appeared in headache. We continue, and this is the research paper, which is in the official journal of International Journal of Ayurvedic Research, published by Department of Ayush. And friends, when we are talking about evidence, fortunately I'm in Bangalore, and there is a lady who is a part of this study. So when we talk about evidence, evidence is not on the paper, but evidence are also visible. This lady had migraine for 6 years, and she had minimum 6 to 8 attacks, and she had taken all allopathic conventional medicine, and she took medicine for 120 days, and now she completes 5 year disease-free survival. We have many such cases with us. I deal with Rash Shastra. Rash Shastra means, oh my God, he's a criminal. He deals metals, he gives mercury. He should be hanged, he's poisoning the people. I have heard all things in my lifetime. I said, no, our masters, our Rishi Munis were very clear. They knew that these are toxic, and they evolved a methodology how to convert these into non-toxic form. We use 4 medicines. WHO says that if you have to do herbal medicines toxicity, you study each ingredient. I said, how funny it is. I'm not using one ingredient. I'm using complete formulation, which has so many things. And in this case, I'm using 4 formulation. What is the purpose of using single ingredient? I said, sir, I went to Bombay College of Pharmacy. They were not ready to accept my things. I said, sir, I'm giving 4 medicines to the patient. I would like you to do toxicity studies on 4 of all them. There was this logic, because sometimes you combine 2 things together, they can be toxic, they can be good when they are working independently. So we did this OECD parameters in Bombay College of Pharmacy. The maximum lipid was 5 gram. It was well tolerated. And then there was a subacute study for 28 days, and which has been published in an International Journal of Toxicology and Pharmacological Research in the authorship of Dr. M. S. Araf. Then there was a subacute. Any medicines which is given more than 90 days or 90 days should be subjected to subchronic toxicity. That means 180 days active treatment and 30 days without treatment for reversal. We completed that, and result is very evident. There is nothing to show. Well tolerated, no side effect. So message is very clear that we have a proof of concept. We have a clinical evidence that there is an Ayurvedic treatment protocol which brings significant relief, safe, and a new pathway for the scientist to go. So now the current scenario is medicines is being prepared at Dehradun. There are many clinics who are taking this treatment and giving to the patient, but the condition is document your practice. We are not interested in our turnover. You take medicine, but before you take the another one, give us the hisab kitab of pichla. Whether your patient continued or not continued, we are not bothered. Then, by the time, we could sensitize the authorities. Because if I go to Department of Pharmacology, without getting this clinical evidence, they will say, oh, it works. No, we are not interested. But now they have seen the clinical efficacy. Department of Pharmacology of All India Medical Institute, just a minute. Department of Pharmacology, All India Medical Institute, they became our partner. They say it is surprising that none of your medicine has analgesic. How is it working? So we have some animal models, existing model. We would like to do that. We got ethical clearance. We got administrative clearance. And now the study has been started at Department of Pharmacology under Professor Dr. Y.K. Gupta, Head of Pharmacology. Now Department of Neurology, we tried to publish our findings in cephalalgia and headache, but they did not accept it. I said, you are treating, excellent, but you are in India, the system is in India, you should persuade some neurologists who should participate in this program. And now we have a neurologist, neurosurgeon of All India Institute, and neurologists of All India Institute have come together. We have again got ethical clearance, and very soon we are going to do double arm study on migraine patients, on refractory migraine patients, chronic migraine patients. And one more thing, that while we were doing it, I came across with a person who is considered as the authority of migraine in India. He works in a Leelavati hospital and is a slow hospital under migraine clinic. Over the last 2 years, we had shared 7 cases referred by him, and now he's so much sensitized that we are going to set up an integrated clinic in Bombay in collaboration with this. For this, I want to acknowledge IPCA Lab. Finance is a big thing. And again, it is a pity that this work is being sponsored by an allopathic company. I did not get any support other than Dabur India Limited, 5 lakh rupees. This company has already contributed more than 3 crore rupees on this work. All the studies which you are doing in Bombay College of Pharmacy or All India Institute, it is selflessly, without any contract, is being supported by IPCA Lab. I'm thankful to Dr. R.M. Verma, who is not here, Dr. Jayaprakash, all volunteer patients and media who supported our venture, my colleague, Vaidya Raghavendra Babu, Vaidya Suresh Kumar, and all participating Ayurvedic doctors, and collaborative faculty of Bombay College of Pharmacy, Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore, and AIIMS Delhi, who are supporting this work. With these words, I thank all of you for giving me patience hearing. Thank you very much.